All right, Andrew Dice Clay normally does not get up this early. And thus, you've got the supersize.
Giant. I'm here. I'm not awake, though.
Okay.
Doing my job.
This is because you've continued through the overnight, or?
Well, no, I just stay up very late. You know, I go, like, to the comedy store, and, you know, sad to say there was a death in comedy, Ralphie May, who was just one of the great, great comics, from HBO specials to cooking the greatest chicken sauce you ever had.
Oh, really?
You know, yeah, he was a really great guy, and, you know, it wouldn't be nice if I didn't say something.
Okay.
Because I love the guy.
I'm glad you did. Now, you're wearing two merces?
Yeah, I call it two gun.
Okay.
Yeah, it's easier than the thing around the waist.
Right.
Yeah, you can't get this.
No.
What's in there? What do you?
Well, you know, I got, like, the phone.
Okay.
You know what I mean? I got a
chapstick.
You know, whatever I need. Yeah. Weapons. You know, we're on Sunset Boulevard.
Right. You never know. Dice, that show was terrific. Are you happy with the way it's turned out?
Dice, people are really loving it. Mm-hmm. Showtime's been letting me just, you know, be the moron I am when I have to be. You know, it's more fun for me because I get to show other sides of just my stage persona. Mm-hmm. You know, I get to show, you know, the vulnerability, the stupidity, because I'm not, you know, from past experience.
Sure. Yes.
That I'm not the smartest guy in the world.
Yeah.
You know, I've said some things here that I got slapped for, and, you know, but
so are these
but it's more self-deprecating.
Right. Are these,
you know, like you do.
Right, precisely.
You know what I mean? Like, I'm sitting with you now, but normally I'm watching you do what you do.
There, it's self-deprecating.
Yeah, you're funny like that.
Thank you very much. That's nice of you to say. Are you smarter now?
With certain things.
with those things, do the thoughts still come through your mind and then you take a breath and go, 1, 2, 3, no, I won't say it?
It depends what we're talking, like on stage?
No, here. Never.
Right.
Yeah, here, I'll, look how I behave.
Yeah, but on stage?
Look how I behave. They got a SWAT team hanging by. You know, I've done this show where it's gone to dead air, you know.
Right.
And, okay. No, you mature in certain ways.
Sure.
You know, I have, you know, sons I got to teach and they can't just see me being reckless.
You've had great acting chops demonstrated before. You're in this new Star Is Born.
Yeah, that's
a big
exciting. With Bradley Cooper and Lady Gaga, I play her father.
Really?
And she's just she's an amazing actress. Mm. I mean, we know the kind of singer she is, but she's really going to shine. It's the right project for her.
Yeah.
And Bradley Cooper.
Did you say that to her? Hey, Lady Gaga, this is the right project for you.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. Don't you know what A Star Is Born is? It's about?
I know exactly what it's about. Of course.
Okay, so that's what I'm saying. Isn't it perfect for her?
Absolutely. It's perfect.
But she does, you know, it's a very dark, heavy love story.
Sure, absolutely.
So, you know, she's great at it. And most of my scenes are with her. And Bradley Cooper had, you know, the patience with me and really wanted me to play this part. And I got to say, he's like one of the greatest guys I've ever met in Hollywood.
You know, I tell you, what I like about him is every time I met him, there's no aunt. It's just him. There's no like.
You know 20, him?
Yeah.
You've talked to him on the air?
There's not on the air and off the air. And there's not like 25.
Listen, I know you met him, but we're friends.
Right.
You have his phone number.
Yeah, it's a different level of friendship.
Right, I get it.
Like, we're really close.
Right.
Like, I know what his kitchen looks like.
Right. I don't.
You know,
I don't even know what his house looks like.
Do you ever hang out with his mother?
No, I have not.
No, I do.
Okay, well, then you're
You understand? Does he ever call you if he's, like, depressed?
No, does he call you?
Yeah, we talk.
Is he going to come out and see?
I'm telling you, from all the years in Hollywood, like, if you said, who are the nicest two giant movie stars you've ever met? It would be Bradley Cooper and John Travolta.
Oh, that's so nice to hear.
The two nicest guys ever. You know, if I did something on the set that was upsetting to him, which was like every day, you know, I'd like actually feel bad.
Yeah.
You know, and no, but he directed this thing. He really knows his stuff.
Is Bradley a good enough friend that he's going to come out to see you perform at Spotlight 29, October 28th?
Red Rocks.
Or at Red Rocks
Red
in Vegas?
Rocks in Las Vegas. Yeah. I'm excited about
November,
that.
Three dates there.
Yeah, that's, what are the dates again?
I'll tell you, the 9th, 10th, and 11th.
Of what?
Of November.
November, that's right, I'm going there.
Yeah, apparently.
You know, no, I'm excited. Anytime I go into a new hotel and that really wants me there, you know, especially after what Vegas went through, I feel it's important for performers to get on those stages and, you know, because, you know, it was such a tragedy. It hurt me to, I couldn't even leave the house when that happened. Honestly, it was paralyzing. But like 9/11 and any tragedy, that's what I really feel this country is great at, bonding together when they have to. That's why I love the name the United States. That's how I've always been. And so I can't wait to get there and do whatever I could to help with what's happened, but also perform and just make people laugh.
I was just there last week, and Elton John addressed it on stage incredibly well.
Yeah, he's
very inspiring performance. All right.
Wait a minute. So what do you say now? Elton John knows.
They're friends.
You can't take the Bradley Cooper thing personally.
I don't.
Me and him are actors.
I understand that.
You know what I mean?
All right.
With you. Every time I'm here, he starts this.
All right. Like you say name, he gets bigger.
Why doesn't he interview me?
He can't.
Look at him. Look what a handsome man.
Right? No, he isn't.
And a beautiful woman. Weren't you guys dating last time?
No.
All right. We're done.
All right, I'll call you. I always liked her.
Back with more in a little bit. There we go. Good to see you.
Good to see you. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you.